Hey guys, welcome to WPXbox. This is Ashish and we have the Lumia 630 with us. The first dual SIM Windows phone from Nokia and Microsoft, and it comes with the latest Windows Phone 8.1 and also the CN update, which enables the Bluetooth 4.0 and a lot of other features which people are still waiting because Windows Phone 8.1 is coming in June 24th as per the rumors. But yeah, so if you're going to buy the device, you're going to definitely get all the latest update, latest apps and everything which others don't have, but that's a month story. But then, if you're buying 630, you really need to find out if it's really worth it. So a lot of questions came from the users asking me whether I should buy 525 or they should go for 630, or even comparing between 630 and the 635 and so on. So in this video, I'm trying to answer all your questions, including really if this device is worth it, you should really pay 11,500 or 10,500 for this phone. So let's start with design and build quality. Now what you should really notice is what Nokia did here with the design was something really they haven't done before from a different perspective. So for example, it reminds me of the Nokia XL honestly, but if you take a look at the edges of this, it's actually slanting. It's more like it's being rectangular, it's slanted, it's cut on the sides, which gives you an extraordinary grip of the phone. The phone is pretty lightweight and the back side or the rear side is actually matte finish, which gives you an excellent grip of the phone. So from design, look and feel, you'll feel it when you hold the phone, you actually feel it very different from the other Lumia phone. I've used a lot of Lumia phones and this is something different. It gives a 4.5 inch factor, the form factor, it's pretty lightweight. Then the build quality looks brilliant. It's not a polycarbonate body, but you know, the rear case comes out, but even then the phone is rock solid when you have this phone as one unit. So from design and perspective and the usage of buttons, yeah, I should have mentioned that before. So this phone is pretty thin, the phone is sleek. So what happened, that the button was also, you know, it's like their designation has been demoted and they're pretty thin here. So being thin, you actually have to get used to pressing the phone, pressing the button. So I've used the 1020, so I know how it's easy to press because the buttons are big and they're more, you know, responsive. Now I won't say that's not responsive here, but it's thin, and the same as the Lumia 1320, the buttons were pretty slim, so you really have to get used to that fact. That said, this phone also misses the camera button. Now there's a debate on whether you should have a camera button or not, but honestly speaking, what I've seen is if I use a power button or the physical button when taking a picture, the movement of hands can actually shake the pictures. However, if you take it using a soft button, it is more stable. That's when, you know, there's a theory about it, you should go out and read it. So that's about the design and build quality. You can, you know, don't worry about it, go ahead with it. Display and screen quality. Now if you are looking at the screen, you can see how much readable it is in the sunlight or even in the bright light. I have a lot of light coming from the front, so you know, and still you can still see the screen. That's the real factor. The phone comes with clear black display, which makes it possible, so you get the clear black display. And the phone has also 221 ppi or pixel per something, pixel per inches or whatever, which makes the screen looks really, you know, SD quality. Now even though it's not a SD quality screen, but the overall feeling, what I have seen honestly in the 1520, it gives me the same kind of feeling, and this is not even close to that. But even then, the kind of richness in colors, the kind of display you would get even when playing games, you can actually feel that. Talking about the screen quality, now the phone is IPS LCD, which forms the inner layer over which you have the Gorilla Glass 3. Having Gorilla Glass 3 on a, you know, budget phone is really helpful because you don't need to put a screen guard right over there, because Gorilla Glass 3 makes sure that it's scratch resistance most of the time. Now you cannot take a key and, you know, scratch it like heavily, but when you put it in your pocket along with the keys, it really works out. It doesn't put scratches and all. Performance. This is a phone, it's a budget phone which has 512 MB RAM. Now it's 2014, a lot of people are cribbing or whining about like why this phone doesn't have 1 GB of RAM. I'd partly agree to that, because having 512 MB RAM in the phone, you actually, you know, increase the work hours of the developers to make it compatible with 512 MB RAM. However, both the gaming performance and the application performance really worked out well on the 630. The reason being is, first is Windows Phone 8.1 is heavily optimized. In fact, Windows Phone has been always optimized for 512 MB RAM. Otherwise, 525 wouldn't have sold, or even 520 wouldn't have sold like hotcakes over there. So application, I've used WhatsApp, I've used Mail, my Twitter client, favorite ones, Facebook, I've uploaded pictures, I do a lot of gaming. So I've played Asphalt 8 Airborne on it, I've played Temple Run on it. You should go and check out the video which I have already demoed before, which tells me that there is no problem with the performance of the phone. There's no lag absolutely, especially frame drops and all gaming is not there. The primary reason is because it uses a Snapdragon 400 processor which has a Adreno GPU, and it's really really brilliant. And the best part is I played for gaming like 1 hour and there was no heating in the phone. This is really impressive because even my 1020 heats up a lot when playing the games. Camera. So how does 630 performs when it comes to the camera? Really, no flash there. So this is not a big deal that your night photographs won't come out really good. I've tried out, it really fails. However, the dim light and, you know, not really low light, but I would say dim light where you have light, but it's not in the proper conditions. And the daylight photographs were okay, there isn't a problem with that. Now, you cannot get everything in a budget phone, but missing a flash is something many people, you know, are very peculiar about it, that they should have a flash on the phone, because even all the low budget phones have flash on it. But let me tell you, I'll show you some camera samples which you should take a look. The daylight photographs are perfect. While there is a little noise in that, I'll agree to that. It's a 5 megapixel camera, obviously. And the low light photograph or the dim light photographs are, you know, they oversample it, and you know, colors look really like unnatural. It's like a lot of colors have been poured into that. So from camera's perspective, I'll say it's a okay phone. And if you are really very keen to a camera perspective, you know, thing, you shouldn't be buying a 630 because there is not even a flash in that. So that is a big disappointment. So yes, I would expect Nokia not to skip flash on their phones because it really matters to the users, because the phones like the Asha 503, which costs like 6,500, has a 5 megapixel camera and a flash in it. That's really, you know, astonishing. So probably in future version of Windows Phone, we'll see people not missing on the flash and all. But yep, that's the story. How's the battery life of the phone? It's really surprising because many of you expected that the phone, because I have some pre-comments on my blog and, you know, on over newsletters and all, people were a little conservative about, you know, a pretty doubt about that the 630 battery performance will not be really good. But to your surprise, 630 really performed well. So for example, it ran for like 15 hours straight on a 90% charge, and it worked out throughout the night, and only phone turned off only when I turned it on during the daytime when I got up, and it went into, you know, low battery and then it shut off. So, you know, that kind of battery life you're expecting, that something is over 3G and Wi-Fi. So it's not just, you know, just Wi-Fi and all. Now, when I use it over 3G, the phone lasted for like 15 to 16 hours again. But then again, you know, where it varies depending on the usage. So if you put it completely on 3G and play a lot of music and play a lot of games and all, expect the battery to be around like 14 hours. Third day test, which I did on the third day, what happened was I was using a lot of gaming, I was playing a lot of music, and I kept it on Wi-Fi and no 3G, so the mobile data was completely off, and then it lasted for straightforward 24 hours. That's really astonishing, because now people who are astonished, now let me tell you, the phone comes with 1830 mAh battery. In 1020 I have 2000 mAh battery with the advanced processor, which makes sure the battery consumption is less, and the optimized OS, it makes sure your battery really lasts long. So from battery perspective, expect on an average, now if I take a volume sample, probably it will expect to stay from 14 to 15 hours on an average, being on Wi-Fi, being on 3G. So that's the range you are looking for. Motion sensor. So this is a new feature that is coming up with all the new Windows phone to 930, 630, 1520, and it's because of the processor, the Snapdragon 800 and the 400 processor has something called as motion sensor, which can find out if you're actually moving, and if you're moving, it can actually track it. What is the use of that? Now, there are a lot of people who are very keen on their fitness and they want to track down all their calories. So it's good for them because they need not to buy something like a Fitbit Flex like I am wearing right now. So it will still work out. And you know, the APIs are open. It uses the Nokia sensor API. This means any application like the MyFitness app, MyFitnessPal, or even the FlexFit and all, if they have the open API, they can connect to the app, they can take out the data and put it in their log. So let's say if you're using a lot of devices and you have forgotten your Fitbit Flex, and you can still use this to, you know, transfer your data over there, and you can still count on your steps. How the Lumia 630 speakers doing? How is it when it comes to listening to songs, using your headphones or Bluetooth headphones, whatever you have? So when it comes to speakers, I'll take down into different parts. The first is the loudspeaker part, which is right here on a Windows phone on one corner, which is the external speaker. And the second part is when you use it with the headphones. So when it comes to the speakers, 630 speakers are really disappointing because the loudness is really, you know, it's like tearing up when you play it really loud. If you play it in a mid-range, it's okay. But when you go loud, if you're a kind of person who loves to listen to this music louder, the speakers and the bass is going to disappoint you. But if you play it with your headphones, it's really perfect. You know, there's no problem at all. You can control your volumes and everything is there. But here's another disappointing part. Lumia 630, like the Lumia 525 and the 520, doesn't have the equalizer. This is a very important factor for many music lovers who like to have their presets and all available on the phone, but this is missing. When we went to the settings and we checked the audio, this part is actually gone. There's no Dolby support as well. However, Lumia phone or the Windows phone comes with really awesome apps like Nokia Mix Radio, which plays local music, and you can even download music for India. You have unlimited subscriptions for worldwide. It's like available on subscription rating, premium quality music. Then you have the music player on the Windows phone as well, which you can play, shuffle and all those stuff. So from the control perspective, is okay. The only thing missing is the equalizer. One of the major disappointing part was when you play your music keeping your phone down like this, the speakers actually get blocked here. This wasn't the case with a couple of phones which have, you know, their rear part really bumped a little upwards, which actually gave some space to the speakers. But with 630, that's not the case. Sensors. Now, why I'm taking this into the review is because Nokia 6 Lumia 630 misses two important sensors, the proximity sensor and the ambient sensor. Now, why these two are important? The proximity sensor is used to detect if something is pretty close enough. So let's say if you got a call and you're on a call, you notice that your phone usually gets turned, or the display used to turn off, and even the touch response used to get disabled. This is not the case with 630 because the proximity sensor which used to be here is gone. That means when you are taking a call, make sure you are going to lock your phone. The second sensor which is missing is the ambient sensor. So ambient sensors, the main purpose is it detects how much brightness you have outside world, and then, you know, adjusts the display accordingly. Those impacts on the battery life really huge. That is also missing. So what you need to do is, and this is one reason why you will see that the 630 out of retail pack has the ambient sensor, the brightness settings right pinned up. This means they really knew this fact and they have given an option to user to change the brightness as they require instantly, but that's a different part. So these two sensors are missing in the Lumia 630. Windows Phone 8.1. Now there are a couple of features which you might be looking for. For example, moving apps to SD card is there, Bluetooth 4.0 is there, so low light, low energy connecting to devices is possible now. You can move your apps to SD card. The SD card is supported for 128 GB, and then you have notification center, SMS backup, automatic upload, high resolution upload, support for VPN, notification center, and so on. So there are a lot of features from OS perspective. Like if I have to go back 1 year back, you know, it would have been really disappointing. But now I'm very confident recommending Windows Phone to any user because the OS as feature wise is now squared up with all the OS, the Android and the iOS, so there's no limitations there. Value for money. So is the Lumia 630 really value for money phone? Should I go buy Lumia 630 or should I, you know, go and buy the 525 or the 520 or the Nokia X? Now I'll tell you, this is a second generation phone as per me, or even the third generation phone, because they come up with a Snapdragon 400 processor. These series 200, 400 and the 800 series of Snapdragon really makes the phone the phone which you are actually looking for. It's very optimized for your battery performance. It brings in motion sensors. Then it gives you the kind of gaming experience you should be getting on any of the Windows phone and all those stuff. 520 and 525 are your back phone, which doesn't have the hardware which 630 has. So from that perspective, 630 is actually the Lumia 520 of this generation of phone of the 8.1. So if you're looking for Windows phone in dual SIM, Lumia 630 is really a great buy, I would say. I'm not going to compare it right now with any other of the Android phone, not in this video, will come with the next video, but this phone is not disappointing, definitely. So 630 as a dual phone with Windows Phone 8.1 is really not disappointing. You should actually go and try it out if your friends have, especially the dual SIM smart features, which allows you to switch SIM easily while texting, while calling. It even, you know, remembers your call preferences, which SIM you used to make which calls. It even has call diversion, the inbuilt call diversion, which allows you to, you know, if you were talking on one phone and the other phone, if somebody calls you on the other line, it can divert to you to the first number so that you get a busy tone and you don't miss the call. So that's how smart is it. So overall, 630 has been done well. The features are really good. And if you're buying a Lumia 630 from a dual phone perspective, I really recommend it to you.